how doctors can predict which patients are more likely to die of COVID-19. There are a number of studies that have come out about COVID-19 prognosis. Based on a recent one in the journals of Annals of Rheumatic Studies, we now have a powerful way to predict which patients with COVID-19 pneumonia are more likely to die and more likely to require longer stays in the hospital. This is thanks to researchers at Temple University in Philadelphia, who were able to come up with a statistical model that can accurately predict this. Not 100% accuracy, but pretty close. We already know that less than 15% of people who get COVID-19 have severe disease to the point of requiring hospitalization, and less than 5% of people who get coronavirus require ICU. For those with COVID-19 pneumonia who do require ICU, and for some other patients in the hospital who might not necessarily need ICU, these are the patients who have the cytokine storm that we keep hearing about, meaning the immune system is going haywire and there's a ton of inflammation taking place in the body, especially in the lungs. For example, here's a CT scan of one of my patients who, as of the making of this video, is barely clinging to life. 70-year-old male who's otherwise healthy, he has type A blood, so not only does he have COVID-19 pneumonia, but he has ARDS as well, acute respiratory distress syndrome. He's on maximum ventilator support, and we're giving him the maximum amount of oxygen. And we've tried every tool in our arsenal to try and get him better, including proning, APRV mode of ventilation, nitric oxide, the whole nine yards. And despite all that, we still can't get his oxygenation to adequate levels. The cytokine storm has caused his lungs to be flooded with inflammation, which dramatically impairs his lungs' ability to move oxygen from the air and into his bloodstream. Unfortunately, he is highly unlikely to survive. And yes, the overall case fatality rate of COVID-19 is estimated to be around 0.5 to 1%. The case fatality rate only indicates the mortality rate among documented cases because about 30 to 40% of cases are either asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic. That means there are a lot of undiagnosed cases. And most of us by now already know the COVID-19 risk factors that make certain people more prone to having more severe illness: older age, medical comorbidities like heart disease, diabetes, hypertension, obesity, smoking, being a male, having type A blood. But now we have a more specific way of predicting who is more likely to develop cytokine storm and therefore more likely to die, and who's more likely to require a longer stay in the hospital. And it's based on the blood work we get when patients are hospitalized. When we get blood work, we're doing various lab tests, most commonly a complete blood count or a CBC, but also a complete metabolic panel or a CMP. We often check other things like troponin, D-dimer, LDH, ferritin, and CRP or C-reactive protein. A complete blood count is specifically looking at three things: levels of hemoglobin, platelets, and white blood cells. We can see not only total number of white blood cells, but also the breakdown of the percentages of the types of white blood cells, meaning what percentage are neutrophils, monocytes, lymphocytes, eosinophils, and basophils. Lymphocytes generally make up about 15 to 45% of white blood cells. This is very important as it pertains to COVID-19, and you'll see why in a little bit. The CMP, or complete metabolic panel, that's looking at levels of sodium, potassium, chloride, bicarbonate, blood urea nitrogen, creatinine, glucose, calcium, bilirubin, albumin, and liver enzymes like AST, ALT, and alkaline phosphatase. Some of these also have important implications when it comes to COVID-19 disease severity and prognostic implications. Because in the recent study done at Temple University, they analyzed over 500 hospitalized COVID-19 patients, all of which had inflammation in their lungs that was seen on a CAT scan of the chest. They determined the criteria for COVID-19 cytokine storm as follows. Okay, one is they had to have inflammation that was seen on the chest. That was part of the initial diagnostic criteria. So it's either CT of the chest or chest x-ray that shows these infiltrates, or sometimes we call them ground glass opacities. That's what we're talking about here when you do imaging of the chest. Okay, number two is having a ferritin level of more than 250. Number 3 is a CRP level more than 4.6. 4 is an albumin level that's less than 2.87, or lymphocytes that's less than 10.2%, or an ANC, an absolute neutrophil count, that's greater than 11. The 5th criteria they needed to meet was having an ALT more than 60, or an AST more than 87, or a D-dimer more than 4,930, or an LDH more than 416, or a troponin level that's more than 1.09. And finally, the 6th criterion that they needed to meet is having an anion gap of less than 7, or a chloride more than 106, or potassium more than 4.9, or a BUN to creatinine ratio of more than 29. So they had to meet all 6 of these criteria. For patients who met these criteria, their length of stay in the hospital was on average 15 days, and that's compared to 6 days if they did not meet the criteria. Mortality was 28.8% in the group that met criteria and 6.6% in those who did not meet criteria. So if they met cytokine storm criteria for COVID-19, their likelihood of dying was 4 times higher. And maybe you're wondering, how accurate was this prediction model? It was pretty accurate, as this study had a specificity of 79% and a sensitivity of 85%, which is a lot of predictive power. Most of the patients who met criteria for the cytokine storm did so at the time of admission or shortly after they were admitted to the hospital. And this suggests that there's an early and rapid progression in these patients, and also suggests that there's a low likelihood of developing cytokine storm after 10 days of hospitalization. So based on these specific lab parameters, this is how doctors can predict which patients are more likely to die of COVID-19. And I do find that this study correlates with what I've seen in my personal experience with hospitalized COVID patients. And yes, the man whose CT scan I showed you earlier in this video, he met all of these criteria for the cytokine storm, and he did so as soon as, at least within 24 hours of being admitted to the hospital. So that's all I got for this one. In my next one, I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet. Maybe it's going to be on the new vaccines that are coming out. There's the Moderna vaccine, but there's also the new monoclonal antibody treatments that have potential. Or maybe you want me to make a video on something else. Either way, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. And if you haven't done so already, hit that subscribe button and that bell notification, and you'll be notified of when my next one comes out.